If you allow your pain or the world pain to be expressed through an artistic process, you will see alchemy in progress. Jinky 64, with the shadow of confusion, the city of illumination, and it's the path of imagination. My wisdom story. My grandparents suffered unspeakable cruelty during the war. They managed to escape with my parents just before the rest of their family was brutally killed. They never spoke of what happened, and my parents knew not to ask. Instead of looking back, my parents devoted their lives to providing their children a safe and secure future, free of persecution. By focusing on our successful assimilation and keeping our family's pain snuggle under the rug. As a young girl, I wanted to please them, so I did my best to imitate those around me and kept my questions about our family's past to myself. But I felt out of place, like something essential was off. To the outside world, my family seemed perfect. But at home, it felt like living with a herd of elephants in the room. I often felt confused and uneasy, figuring I was just too sensitive, intense and weird. When the pain of not knowing where we come from got too great, I became determined to solve the mystery. I secretly studied all there was to know about the country my grandparents came from and my family's own tragic history in the war. Finally, it made sense. The sheep-like behavior, the stubborn evasiveness about the past. At first, my revelations lessened my confusion and increased my compassion towards my parents. But when they still refused to talk about any of it, I became angry with them for refusing to deal with their pain or talk about anything that actually mattered. I was tired of being repressed by their repression. One day, when I couldn't take it anymore, I cruelly accused my parents of cowardice, and then I flaunted graphics, pictures from their past in front of them. Suddenly, in the midst of our outburst, my father clutched his chest in pain. Though he survived the heart attack, I was devastated and unable to forgive myself. Wracked with guilt, I found a counselor who specialized in healing the wounds of history. With his support, I learned how, through my relentless attempts to end the confusion, I was avoiding my own pain, just like my family. So I let my mind go blank and my heart feel the pure suffering of my people. That's when the miracle started and my imagination was unleashed. Now my life is a work of art and everything I do is infused with the kind of light that can only emerge through darkness. My gift to you. I come to set your imagination free, but first you must bless your pain and confusion with the gift of your awareness. In the presence of confusion, there is nothing to do, nowhere to go, nothing to figure out. Confusion is a totally natural human state. It is actually holy ground. So taste it, embrace it, but do not try to change, interpret it, or get rid of it. As soon as you remember that you are not your confusion, its true diamond nature will emerge from the coil, and your imagination will be released so that you can give expression to your pain and inner demons through a fulfilling process of creativity. Whether you're expressing with a paintbrush or a pen, be honest, courageous, illogical, and wild. Go where no one else has gone before. To dive deeper into your 64, you can ask yourself the following questions. What are the ways you avoid feeling pain and confusion? By fitting in, overthinking, keeping busy, getting angry? Where are you still hiding your originality? How do your current relationships reinforce your hiding? Think of a time when you made room for your imagination. At this moment, what causes you the most pain or confusion? Find a way to express your pain, fear or confusion creatively. Don't make it great art, make it honest. That's it for now. Much love and happy contemplating.